Hello, Mordale. You might have been wondering what we, slash I, am doing here. Well, I have asked myself the same question, but since we are no longer permitted to have in-school assemblies until further notice, we will be hosting a virtual assembly each week. Even though I could be sat in my garden, minding my own business. Now, these are very unique circumstances, and I appreciate it will take some getting used to. But I'm glad that now I have a mute button for all of you, so I don't have to hear your blithering. And yes, I'm looking at you, Gibbs. It goes without saying that we have to set some new, very important ground rules. Number one, stay at home. Number two, no canoodling in the park, or indeed, eyebrow touching in the pool. And three, in the words of Eric Effiong, wash your hands, you... etc., etc. We will be doing other key announcements here, which the AV Club have kindly volunteered to help with from their separate homes, and we'll use this as an opportunity for informative and educational discussions, starting with a meeting about everyone's pets.
Oh, for God's sake. He's very smelly. He's very noisy. He loves food. That's pretty much all he loves. Gives you a look as if he is literally going to have a heart attack if you don't feed him.
So, I don't have any real-life pets, unfortunately. I used to have a goldfish called Alan Rickman, but he died. And it was terribly sad. But someone I've always had is this little critter, Tina. She's 3 weeks older than me. My mum had to be in hospital for 3 months before she had me, because the doctor had to keep an eye on us both. And there were these lovely ladies who ran a gift trolley. And yeah, a few weeks before I was born, Mum bought Tina for me. She used to have a very big, proud straw hat. Now that's all that remains of the straw hat. But yes, so I've had her ever since. Lovely, lovely Tina.
Hello there. We're introducing you to the pets that are keeping us going through lockdown. So I thought I'd introduce you to the pea plant that we've been growing. There he is. And it doesn't require much. Just a bit of water, bit of care and attention. And we've got him a climbing frame there. Keep him busy over the next few weeks.
Yeah, it's a sad state of affairs, isn't it?
Hello, this is Jim. Young James, just taking him out for a walk. Smells a bit of sheep poo. And he's a bit hairy because we missed his hair appointment. But you know, all's going well.
Jim!
Are you jealous?
Because that's who's keeping me company during this quarantine. Do you like how I did that? Bill fucking Murray. Telling each other sweet nothings and bantering and flantering. Just me and him.
Check this one. Last supper of Bill Murray right here. Me at the top.
I often find myself peeling through the pages and asking for guidance and wisdom, to which I do receive. What more could you ask for? The big Bill gazing back at you. Look at this one. Bill Murray faces making a Bill Murray face. Next to another Bill Murray face. Stay indoors, kids. Wash your hands. Watch Netflix. Bill Murray did not approve of this message in any way, shape or form. So I'm sorry, Bill, but I love you. I love you, Bill Murray.
Good morning, Mordale. I'd like to introduce you to my dogs, Mara and Zooey. Mara and Zooey. As you can see, they are incredibly well-trained. They're as well-trained as the students at Mordale. It has nothing to do with the fact that both my hands are full of small chunks of cheese. Anyway, the only way to tell them apart is to do their tricks. They have basically one each. It's not a huge repertoire, but it is a trick nonetheless. So let's find out which one is which. Come on. Now, Mara's trick is this. This is how I know it's Mara.
Good girl. Good girl.
And Zooey's trick is something a little more Mordale. High five.
Good girl.
High five.
Good girl.
And these, therefore, are my dogs. Yet no more bell. No more bell.
You want some cheese? You want some cheese? You want some cheese?